Hi, this is a quick video on how to access a device behind the Comset router. This device can be an IP camera, a PLC, a controller, a data logger. It can be anything that you want to remotely access behind the router. Let's begin. The first thing we need to do is to access the GUI interface of the Comset router. The IP address is 192.168.8.1. Here we can see the cell status is up, so we are connected to the network, and we have obtained a WAN IP address, 120.157.41.213. The first thing we need to do is to test this WAN IP address. So I'm going to copy it. Next thing is I'm going to disconnect the cable, unplug the cable. And as you can see now, I'm connected via Wi-Fi to the ADSL modem router here in the office. Open a new tab and paste the IP address and hit enter. Here you go, I am connected over the internet to the router. The next thing I need to do is to check my connection between the router and the IP camera. If we go to network settings, LAN, what I did here is I used the MAC address of the IP camera. This is the MAC address of the IP camera, and I assigned a fixed IP address to this MAC address. And I used a IP address within the range start IP and IP, which is 192.168.8.100 and 192.168.8.200. This is using DHCP on the IP camera. Of course, you can use static IP if you want to, and in this case you will assign a static IP on the IP camera within the same range. Now, to test this connection, you go to administration, scroll down, system command, and you type in the IP address. Of the IP camera. Well, you need to ping it, of course. Ping 192.168.8.110. And as you can see, we are getting replies. Okay, so let's recap. The first thing we need to do is to test the WAN connection, and we were able to connect over the internet to the WAN IP address. And the second step is to test the LAN connection, and we were able to here get a reply and the LAN connection between the router and the IP camera. The next thing we need to do is port forwarding. So if you go to firewall, port forwarding, enable port forwarding, and the IP address we said is 192.168.8.110, and the port on the IP camera is port 88. And we type in a comment here, camera, and hit apply. Now the rule is created. Let's go back to port forwarding, and as you can see, we have the port forwarding rule. Now we should be able to access the IP camera from the internet using the WAN IP address and column 88. Let's try that. Open new tab. So we put column 88, and there you go. Now we have accessed the IP camera. sitting behind the Comset router. Now, can I go back to the status page, the public IP address that I mentioned earlier can be a dynamic or a static IP address. If it is a static IP address, you don't have to do anything. But if it is dynamic, as is the case here, this will change all the time. So there are two ways around it. One is you can send an SMS to the router every time with the command cell status, and it will come back to you with a set of parameters, including the WAN IP address at the time. Or what's commonly used is dynamic DNS, and I'll show you how we use dynamic DNS. So you go to management in the administration folder, scroll down, and here we have dynamic DNS. I have used dindns.org, but you can use any dindns from the list, and I created an account on dindns.org website, and here we have the host name comsetsupport.dvrdns.org. I'm going to copy this, open new tab. Now if I enter this, you access the Comset router. Open another tab, but if you put column 88, you access the IP camera configuration page. Thank you for watching.